Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and Ranking Member Cardin, and members of the committee. It's a pleasure to be back here. It's the second time in less than a couple of weeks. It's not often I darken the door at the Foreign Relations Committee, but as long as the President keeps nominating Texans, I promise to come back often. I can't think of a better nominee to an important ambassadorship in Brussels than our dear friend Kay Bailey Hutchison. She truly is someone who needs no introduction, but I'm going to give her one anyway. I had the honor of serving alongside of Kay for 10 years in the Senate, and when I got here, there were some things that I figured out pretty quickly about her. Number one, she is tireless. You would be hard-pressed to find a senator in the chamber who worked harder than Kay Hutchison. Second, she was relentless. She would not stop until she achieved her objective. And most importantly, she always did what she thought was the right thing for Texas. Whether it was working with Republicans or Democrats, that was always her guiding star. As I think about the type of individual best suited to represent the U.S. on the world stage, I can't think of no one better than Kay. She's always been a trailblazer. After graduating from the University of Texas Law School, she became the first female on-air news reporter in Houston. And years later, she became the first woman to represent Texas here in the Senate. When she was here, as you'll recall, her leadership was quite evident. She served as a ranking member of the Commerce, Science, and Transportation Committee and chair of the Republican Policy Committee. Kay is not, was not, and is not afraid of working across the aisle. It's the way she was able to get so much done during her time here, not only on behalf of Texas, but on behalf of the nation. She's always been a fierce advocate for military families. It's no exaggeration to say that every base in our state has felt the impact of her work. And she's worked hard for veterans to make sure they get the medical assistance, the job training, and support they needed when they came home. And she's worked hard to promote things like tax relief for hardworking Texas families. And she made it easier for women to save for their retirement and work to reduce the unfair marriage penalty tax. During her time here, Kay served on the Intelligence Committee, the Armed Services Committee as well. So I know that promoting American global leadership and strong diplomacy guided her committee work and will prepare her well for her duties in Brussels. So I think her time in this chamber was instructive as to how she'll serve in this new position. We are, as we all know, in a time of increasing instability across the globe. And now more than ever, our friends and allies need a determined and steady hand representing the United States. Senator Hutchison has the experience, determination, and tact required for our representative to Brussels, and there's no one better prepared to successfully navigate and strengthen our relationships on the world stage. Kay will do it, and she'll do it with poise and grace. So I look forward to supporting her confirmation on the Senate floor, and once again, thank you, Mr. Chairman, Senator Cardin, and members of the committee for allowing me to say a few words on behalf of Kay Bailey Hutchison.
We thank you.